Well, it's basically the word internet, right? It's a bunch of networks that are hooked together.
Computers.
Computers. There are things called hubs and switches, and they run on the large cables that hook things together. But the main point of it is that they can be hooked together. So what's really important is that there's an agreement about how information is carried across it. Information is broken up into things that are called packets. And the business of the parts of the internet are to hand packets from one part of it to another. So basically, if you're sitting at home, if you're sitting at home with your computer at home, and you're talking to the BBC news service in England, so that goes through a whole bunch of intermediaries. But the main point is they have all agreed on what's called the format for how to transmit these packets. So if I would like to join the internet and add a new piece to it, all I need to do is agree with this one format about packets. And that's been the critical thing that's made the network successful since the very, very beginning, the fact that there's a standard that everyone has agreed upon. And the other interesting thing about the standard, and it's only about how you transmit the packets. So it's not about, for your part of the internet, you're going to transmit a speech in a special way. It's
right.
That everybody can kind of join the club by just making this agreement about this one standard. So that's the critical thing about the internet.
As I understand it, I thought your example of postcards was great. Right. These packets are like dividing up War and Peace into 25,000 postcards and sending the postcards, and one will go 1 second, another one will go another second, and so on and so forth. And at the other end, it all gets put together, so it comes out War and Peace.
Right, because everybody's, because these things have serial numbers on them, and they say, gee, I'm getting them, and I'm going to put them together in this order.
But the remarkable thing is that the network design was only about postcards, and it's still today only about postcards.
Yeah.
Now, in fact, the thing now runs so quickly, just because of Moore's Law and all of the other advances, that people have figured out how to use this same underlying packet passing protocol for transmitting telephone calls, which essentially the audio gets written down on postcards, dumped into the network. The postcards get delivered very, very quickly, not all through the same route, but they all have serial numbers on. They get reassembled at the other end, and you've got Skype or one of these voiceover.
And the video might go through different packets and the different routes.
Absolutely. Yeah. And they get assembled at the other end.
Yeah.
You know, in the case of a telephone call, you may lose a few packets, but it doesn't really matter because it's only audio, and you wouldn't even notice the difference, hardly. Other kinds of documents, you know, the higher reliability is needed. But so the genius of the original network design was to make the fundamental operation of passing a packet from one link to the next so simple that creative people operating at the ends, the so-called ends of the network, have been able to develop all of these things that were never anticipated in terms of streaming video and internet telephony and all of these applications, which in the 70s, when the internet basics were being worked out, nobody even imagined.
This excerpt is brought to you by the Massachusetts School of Law, the leader of reform in legal education and a leader in multimedia education for the public. To view the full interview and for a full listing of MSL's programs, log on to mslaw.edu.